Thank you. Can we all please rise? Can we all please rise? Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We're thankful that each and every one of you can be here. Now, I must admit, don't they look wonderful? We're thankful, Ben and Gerda, that you can be here. And at this time, as we continue in this service, we'll have a word of prayer. Father in heaven, Lord, we're thankful today for both Ben and Gerda. Lord, we ask today that as they continue to celebrate the fact that you have brought them together and that you will keep them together, that this service will be a blessing to them and to every person under the sound of my voice. Father, we ask that you will tabernacle here with us and bless this couple, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you. At this time, I'm going to ask for Sister Prophet, if you would please read a passage of scripture which comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. First Corinthians chapter 13.
En Corinthiens 13, verset 1er à la fin. Quand je parlerai les langues des hommes et des anges, si je n'ai pas la charité, je suis un airain qui résonne ou une cymbale qui retentit. Et quand j'aurai le don de prophétie, la science de tous les mystères et toute la connaissance, quand j'aurai même toute la foi jusqu'à transporter des montagnes, si je n'ai pas la charité, je ne suis rien. Et quand je distribuerai tous mes biens pour la nourriture des pauvres, quand je livrerai même mon corps pour être brûlé, si je n'ai pas la charité, cela ne me sert de rien. La charité est patiente. Elle est pleine de bonté. La charité n'est point envieuse. La charité ne se vante point. Elle ne s'enfle point d'orgueil. Elle ne fait rien de malhonnête. Elle ne cherche point son intérêt. Elle ne s'irrite point. Elle ne soupçonne point le mal. Elle ne se réjouit point de l'injustice. Mais elle excuse tout. Elle se réjouit de la vérité. Elle croit tout. Elle espère tout. Elle supporte tout. La charité ne périt jamais. Les prophéties prendront fin, les langues cesseront, la connaissance disparaîtra. Car nous connaissons en partie et nous prophétisons en partie. Mais quand ce qui est parfait sera venu, ce qui est partiel disparaîtra. Lorsque j'étais enfant, je parlais comme un enfant. Je pensais comme un enfant. Je raisonnais comme un enfant. Lorsque je suis devenu homme, j'ai fait disparaître ce qui était de l'enfant. Aujourd'hui, nous voyons au moyen de miroirs, d'une manière obscure. Mais alors, nous verrons face à face. Aujourd'hui, je connais en partie, mais alors, je connaîtrai comme j'ai été connu. Maintenant donc, ces trois choses demeurent. La foi, l'espérance, la charité. Mais la plus grande de ces choses, c'est la charité. Que Dieu aille bénir cette portion d'écriture pour l'édification commune de nos âmes.
Amen. At this time, we'll have a special song by the Charles family.
Dès les premiers jours, mes yeux se sont posés sur toi. Je me suis dit que c'est pour la vie. Ton sourire a éveillé une vie en moi. Mais mon cœur brûle de te dire je t'aime, car depuis toutes ces années, malgré les luttes et les tourments, les bons, les mauvais moments, le temps a s'oublié, a partagé, quand j'ai dû persister, bientôt, et si j'ai dû persister, c'est parce que tu étais à mes côtés. La nature n'égalera jamais ta bonté. Tu es mon ami, le Dieu de tout grâce. Si un jour tu partais, je te rattraperai. Car toi et moi s'aiment pour la vie et Dieu nous a unis. Je t'aime, car depuis malgré les luttes et les tourments, les bons, les mauvais moments. Le temps à s'oublier, à partager, car si j'ai dû persister, c'est parce que je t'aime tant, c'est parce que tu étais à mes côtés, c'est parce que tu étais avec moi, tu étais avec moi, tu étais à mes côtés.
Amen, amen. Well, my friends, family, we are gathered here today because this couple have chosen the best decision of their life. Next to giving your life to God, it's giving your life to someone else. And today, Ben and Gerda, we celebrate this time with you because we know that all of heaven is rejoicing. Friends, we are gathered here today to join this man and this woman in holy marriage, which is instituted by God, regulated by his commandments, and blessed by the Lord Jesus Christ. And it's held in honor among all people. By that, the Lord said in Genesis chapter 2 and verses 18, the Lord God said, "It is not good," and I'm paraphrasing, "that Ben should be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." Now the Lord God had formed out of the ground all the wild animals and the birds in the sky and brought them to man to see what he would name them. But then it goes on. After man gave the names of all the livestock, in verse 21, God said, "So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. And when Ben was sleeping, he took one of his ribs, and then God closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made Gerda from the rib which he had taken out of Ben and brought her to Ben. And Ben said, 'This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called Woe Man, for she was taken out of me.'" Today, Ben, Gerda, you all look real good. You dressed up for this occasion. And God brought you all together, and God has blessed you all. God has blessed your home. Ben, all the way in Haiti, you saw this woman, and she's the one of your dreams. She came here to the United States, and you all have a wonderful home. God has certainly blessed you. I went, and as I was contemplating, what in the world should I say, God, to this couple who are experts at love? What should I say? And God brought me back to a conversation I had with a little old lady in church years ago. She said, "I want to tell you something about marriage. There are a few things you must know before you go into it." And I'm going to share with you very briefly those few things that she shared with me. First, she shared, if you want your marriage to be successful, to actually be fruitful, then first, you got to have faith in God. She said, "You know what? Faith in God, everyone claims to have. But seriously, as a couple, you must first designate a place in your home for prayer." That's what God meant when he said, "Two shall be one." Because when you come together in prayer, that will keep whatever issues you have out of your marriage. Number two, first is faith, which means prayer. Second is finance. Your finance. I realize over the years that finance is a major issue in a lot of marriages. In fact, it's the number one cause of divorce. So to divorce-proof your marriage, make sure that your finance is always a top priority. Because you want to make sure that you have a budget every single month to make sure that your marriage stays strong with prayer. Third, she said to me that you got to be fulfilled. Knowing that your spouse understands fully that you love each other. That means that you're going to have to spend time with one another. You can't be married and don't spend time together. You can't say, you know what? I'm going to be married, but no one ever picks up to do the housework. You've got to be able to share, I love you. You've got to be able to share, you know what? Sometimes I'm going to cook a special meal for my spouse. Sometimes I'm going to go out there and buy a special gift for Ben or buy a special gift for Gerda. There are times I'm just going to be passing by and I have to give that special touch. Touch her on some body part. It could be a shoulder. It can be just their cheeks, just to let her know that I love her. Then you can never say it too much. Say, I love you. Say it, wear it out. Even when you might be mad, you might be upset. Oh, I don't know. She did something. I don't know. You better show it and say it. Say, I love you. Make sure every single day, if you need to paste a little note. There was a man who pasted a little note right at his front door, which says, did you say I love you today? So every time he was about to go through the door, he paused and he said, oh, I didn't say I love you today. He went right back and he made sure to say to his wife, I love you. You can't say it too much. Then she said, not only faith, finance, fulfillment, but then she said, you've got to learn to forgive. If your marriage is to stay strong, you've got to forgive. Forgive things of the past. You can't labor on things. What's in the past stays in the past. You focus on what is now and the things that are wonderful now and the things that you're looking forward to going into the future. The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 26, don't let the sun go down on your wrath. Meaning that even though you are upset, ensure that even if you're lying on the bed and one is on the other side and the other one is on the other side and you're looking away and you're so upset, take your foot, put your foot out, put it over there, and you make sure you touch your spouse. Don't kick your spouse, but touch your spouse and let them know, I love you. In spite of the fact I might be upset, I still love you. Then lastly, friends and family. These folks who are here are friends, some are family. Friends and family can either make or break your relationship. And I'm pausing here for a moment. We would all agree, would we not? Friends and family could either make or break your relationship. And that's why God took you out of your home, brought you together, and said, you two, not the whole lot of them, you two are now one flesh. You are one. No one, whether woman, whether man, neither boy or girl, can't come between what you guys have. Because two are better than one. God brought you together, and God is the one who will keep you together. And we will watch on as we begin to see your love continue to grow each and every day. Remember, prayer is truly the key. On that note, we will now have a special song by Juzan. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
My name is Ramil Paul, and I'm represented father, because my father not here now, by the hand of the Lord, but I'm represent his father. But I'm happy because I'm deacon of the church body of Christ, and I'm happy for that the ministry doing today. This has that make me satisfied about both of them. Because I'm in Jesus Christ's life too.
Amen. Yeah.
Can we say amen to that?
Amen.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Paul. Now I'm going to ask at this point, Ben, if you would, as you have Jada, their little one, and Gerda, if you would hand those flowers over to someone at this time. And if you both will take each other's hand, wonderful. If you would take each other's hand at this time and look deep into each other's eyes, wonderful. Ben, you are first. I,
Bernard,
take you
to be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
What is her name?
Gerda.
To have and to hold. From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness or in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us apart. According to God's holy ordinance. And thereto. I pledge you my love. All right.
Amen.
Okay.
I. Gerda.
Thank you. To be my wedding husband. To have and to hold. From this day to hold. For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God, holy and pious.
And thereto. I pledge you my love. All right, wonderful.
Amen.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to have a special word of prayer over this marriage. For as much as Ben and Gerda have consented together in holy marriage and declared the same before God and in the presence of this company, I pronounce them husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. And the church says,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Father in heaven, Lord, we are thankful today for Ben and Gerda, who you have brought together as husband and wife.
We ask today, O God, that you will bless this union, that you would allow for them to continue to serve you all the days of their life. Father, we pray that you will bless their little one, Jada, that you will keep her, O God. May they continue to instill in her the wisdom that comes from you so that she will grow in your admonition and to love you. Father, we pray for many more little children. We also pray, O God, that you will bless them financially, that you will enlarge their territory, and that you will keep them faithful to one another. Allow for their love to continue to grow. And in the end, O God, when you shall return, you will find them like they are right now, still loving one another, still praising you, and still loving you. As we continue today, Lord, we ask that you will continue to bless them and keep them close to you. And now we will have the continuation of the prayer in Creole.
Amen, amen.
Notre Seigneur, notre Dieu, ce moment est spécial pour dire gloire, louange, l'honneur à toi et à toi seul. Depuis la création, tu as institué cette institution. Malgré la banalité de ce monde, le mariage reste le mariage. Et ce jour-là, Seigneur, Ben et Gerda ont pris la meilleure décision de prendre la main de l'un l'autre et pour la vie. Seigneur, veuille bénir leur union et permet dans ta grâce infinie leur amour soit fleuri et tout le monde confesse non seulement c'est toi qui es Dieu, mais tu es vivant dans leur milieu. Bénis cette cérémonie et permet que Seigneur, jusqu'à ton retour, où seule la mort sera seul élément de séparation. Permet qu'ils soient restés ensemble. Permet qu'ils soient fructifiés. Et d'ores et déjà, Seigneur, veuille bénir leur entourage. Permet que cette union soit la perle de l'amour partout et à travers. Nous réclamons de toi ces faveurs et grâces. Au nom de Jésus, le vivant et régnant, au siècle des siècles. Amen.
We will have the blessing of another song by Sister Charles.
Ils sont là, Seigneur, au pied de ton autel, ils recherchent ta présence. Toi qui as créé l'amour, d'ailleurs tu l'as dit, l'homme quittera son père, sa mère et s'attachera à sa femme. Les deux formeront un seul être. Bénis les Seigneurs, car ils veulent te servir. Bénis les Seigneurs, ils désirent faire. Bénis les Seigneurs, ce qui n'est pas facile. Le temps est très dur. L'immoralité grandit, oui, de jour en jour. Mais eux, ils te sont fidèles. Bénis les Seigneurs, car ils veulent te servir. Bénis les Seigneurs, ils désirent faire ta volonté, ce qui n'est pas facile. Aide-les, Seigneur, à vivre pour toi et à faire ce qui te plaît. Satan est là pour les séduire, mais la victoire est à toi. Bénis-les, Seigneur, car ils veulent te servir. Bénis-les, Seigneur, ils désirent faire. Bénis-les, Seigneur, ce qui n'est pas facile. Bénis-les, Seigneur, car ils veulent te servir. Bénis-les, Seigneur, ils désirent faire ta. Bénis-les, Seigneur, qu'il en soit ainsi. Bénis-les, Seigneur.
Introducing to each and every one of you, Mr. and Mrs. St. Val. Can we put our hands together? Now at this time, I'm going to step aside because they have a very special moment that they have to celebrate. So we're asking at this time, Ben, you may kiss your bride. And today is Jada's birthday. And she has to be kissed also. Amen. Amen. Folks, can we pray together? Father, we just want to thank you again for this marriage. We thank you for being here, part of Ben and Gerda's journey. And we ask, oh God, a continued blessing upon their union. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you all. Some refreshments and gather together and fellowship one another and celebrate this moment with Ben and Gerda and Jada.